Viruses always have protein coat and a nucleic acid core. They cannot live or reproduce outside the living cells. The size of viruses ranges from 20 to 250 nanometer. They are submicroscopic, cannot be seen with compound microscope. We need electron microscope to see viruses. They reproduce by replication. They produce their copy same as the parent virus. Some viruses are simple viruses. Simple virus uses enzyme of the host cell. Host cell means the cell on which they live for protein synthesis and gene replication. And some viruses are complex viruses that contain up to 200 genes and capable of synthesizing proteins and enzymes themselves, but through their host. They can produce their protein and enzymes, but with the help of their host. Viruses are virulent, extremely severe or harmful in its effects. You can see this is the structure of a complex virus, and in detail we are going to discuss this. This virus is bacteriophage. These are some, not types, these are basically the shapes of the viruses. Helical shape that you have seen, the tobacco mosaic virus. Some are polyhedral, adenovirus, and spherical shape. This is the influenza virus and also the coronavirus, that is spherical shape, and the bacteriophage that affect bacteria. This is a complex virus. Okay, now structure. For structure, you also open your book and come on to page number 75. And whenever you are going to see the video, so you must have your book with you, so that will help you. And read it before the video or after the video. Structure. First, appearance. They appear like small rods, tadpoles, polyhedrals, or little sphere. Viruses consist of nucleic acid, capsid, envelopes, and tail fibers. The protein coat that encloses the nucleic acid is called capsid. You can see in the picture. Inside the here, you can see DNA. DNA means nucleic acid, deoxyribonucleic acid. Nucleic acid may be RNA, ribonucleic acid, or DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid. And that protein coat which encloses this DNA is called capsid. And envelopes, what are envelopes? Some viruses have accessory structures called viral envelopes that help them infect their host. They are membranes covering their capsids. Around the capsids, there are envelopes. And last one are the tail fibers. All right. About the capsid, one more point. Capsid may be of different shapes. Capsid is made up of protein subunits called capsomers. Okay. The smallest viruses have only 4 genes. And the largest viruses have up to 200 genes. So this is the structure of virus. Virus may be considered as living or non-living. What are the points that support that viruses are living? Because viruses possess the genetic material DNA or RNA. I have told you this is nucleic acid, maybe DNA or RNA. Or it also possesses a protein coat. Both are present in living things. They can replicate inside a living cell. They can replicate, reproduce, making its copy. But why they are non-living? Because they are non-cellular. Every living thing is made up of cell. So this is non-cellular. They cannot reproduce by themselves. If they are outside the host, they cannot reproduce. Only have one type of nucleic acid. And both living things have both types of nucleic acids, DNA and RNA. If we compare a virus with a cell, because cell is the basic unit of life, it means cell is living and viruses are non-living. So what are the, we are going to compare them. Structure, they have DNA, RNA core and capsid. And the difference you can see in the cell, cell membrane, cytoplasm and organelles. These are not present in virus. Reproduction only within the host cell, and cell can reproduce by